Hey guys, hope you're all doing well. This video is all about my hair. If you have been following me for a fairly long time, basically since I pretty much started YouTube, I have always pretty much had a very long blonde head of hair. It's been long, it's been thick, it's been really healthy. And then I guess a few years after starting YouTube, probably about 3-4 years in, it all kind of started to change. And I had taken my hair for granted. I always just assumed it was always going to be long and healthy and I could dye it as much as I want and it's always gonna remain, you know, in that really good condition. But alas, it did not. It wasn't like an overnight thing where it just all went downhill. It was very gradual to the point where I didn't really realize it was happening until it was too late. My hair went from long and thick and healthy and blonde, like a nice blonde, to medium length, maybe extremely ratty, thin, wispy ends that would snap and break at any given moment. Really, really blonde, like it kind of went on another level of blonde, and it just wouldn't grow. My hair grows fast. When my hair is in the right condition, it grows fast. It wouldn't grow. And so I thought, okay, I gotta make a change now. And that is what I'm gonna talk to you about in this video. What I did, what I changed, what habits I put in place to get it back to the healthy state that it used to be in. My hair now, it's been about, I think about a year since I did all these changes, and I don't know if you can see, I just got my hair done, so you can't see as much as well as you used to be able to, but my regrowth is about, literally about here. So my hair has grown that much in a year, and normally your hair grows 12 centimeters in a year, which is what, like that much. It's almost growing like 20 centimeters maybe. It's crazy. The number one thing I did, the number one thing that I recommend to everyone, and it's the most basic thing that everyone knows, but hardly anyone does. Cut your hair. I was under the impression that, oh no, I want long hair, so I'm never gonna cut it because that way it'll keep growing and just get longer and longer and longer and my hair will be back to normal in no time. Hell no. When my hair started to go downhill, it was so ratty and weak at the ends that I know that it was just full of split ends. If you don't cut your split ends off, that little split will keep on unraveling up the hair strand and then it'll just snap off. And if it doesn't unravel, it'll just snap off anyway. When you're brushing your hair, it'll snap off. When you're blow drying your hair, it'll snap off. When your hair is in a ponytail, it'll snap. It'll just snap at any moment because it's not in a good condition and it needs to be cut off. If you've got freshly cut ends, all of those ends are fresh. It's like a fresh start. And even if the hair quality needs to be improved, if it's over bleached or whatever, it's still a lot better having a freshly cut end than having ends that may be a little bit longer, but are just in terrible condition. Because the longer they stay in that condition, the shorter your hair is going to get. And it gives your hair a chance to actually grow instead of growing and then snapping straight off. I ended up only cutting like that much off, which is nothing. I was thinking in my head it was gonna be like this much hair, but it was literally nothing because my hair was already so wispy at the ends that it pretty much looked like I didn't even do anything to my hair because it was that crap. I ended up cutting my hair to about maybe here. That was probably the shortest it had been. And it instantly felt incredible. I can't forget that feeling when I ran my fingers through my hair. And I was like, oh my God, it feels so thick and amazing. In my opinion, and I know a lot of hairdressers share the same opinion, I would rather have shorter, healthier hair than longer, unhealthy, ratty, wispy hair. Like, I feel like healthy hair is attractive no matter what length it is. Unhealthy hair is probably not ideal no matter what length it is. For this past year, I've made the conscious decision to keep my hair short at this shorter length. Just because I wanted to embrace having shorter hair. I've never had hair this short before in my life since I was, like a kid pretty much. And so I committed to it. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna keep this hair style. I'm gonna keep this length. I'm gonna just let my hair do its thing. Give it a year to recover, which sounds like a long time, but honestly, it has gone by like that. I haven't even, there's not one moment where I've been like, oh, it's taking ages. In fact, I've been like, crap, my hair is growing really fast. I need it trimmed again. That's why my hair doesn't look that long at the moment. It's because I've been continually cutting it and cutting it and cutting it and keeping it at that length. Now I've decided to let it grow out, so that's why it's a little bit longer than it normally is. As I said earlier, I went to the hairdresser yesterday and still continue to get a trim. Even though I'm trying to grow it out, I'm still getting trims because I know that not getting trims does not equate to longer hair. Getting trims means getting longer hair. Secondly, relax on the hair dye. I mean, yeah, that was hard for me because I had oh, I look back on it now, it was so overdone. It was too much for me, like me personally. Other people can pull it off, but I just don't like that on me anymore. It was like ultra blonde, and I didn't even realize it was that blonde until a year later, and I looked back and I was like, whoa, it was like translucent. So for that last year, I let my roots grow out. Don't be fooled, I did obviously go to the hairdresser and get like highlights. I gave it a break from all of like the full-on, like a full head of foils that I used to get of just bleach pretty much. Plus, shorter hair is very trendy right now. Having like a shorter long bob type thing, very trendy, so it's a great time to cut your hair. Also, having natural roots, the whole balayage thing, is so in trend. I hate saying that, it's so gross, but it is. It's popular, it's what everyone seems to be doing with their hair these days. Not that you need to follow trends, I mean, stuff that, but if you are like me and you like to kind of lay low and not stand out amongst a crowd, I think it's like the perfect time to let your hair have like a complete detox. Number three is an obvious one. Be kinder on your hair with heat tools. I mean, think about it. If I touch my hair straightener accidentally, it burns my soul. But that's like going on my hair. That is like every single day, not every single day, but like often I'm putting this like 1,000,000,000 degree heat on my hair. And if that burns my fingers, imagine what it does to your hair. That's just horrifying to think of. Coming out of the shower and not blow drying your hair, or waiting at least, you know, till your hair is about 80-85% dry naturally. And then if you need to go in with the hair dryer and like kind of style it or smooth it down, whatever you need. And again, with a straightener, just try to ease up. If it means you need to kind of wear your hair up or in a plait or something some days instead of always having it down, that's awesome. Four, I took hair vitamins for a while. I've stopped at the moment because the ones that I was using have fish oil in them and I am not down with that, so I'm going to find a new brand that is vegan. Basically, most of these pills contain biotin, and that really helps with the growth of your nails, your hair. It kind of nourishes the hair from the inside out, provides your hair with the kind of vitamins and minerals and all that kind of good stuff that it needs to grow. Just make sure that it's safe to take them if you're pregnant or you're on other medication. Make sure that you do your research and you know that it is safe to take them, of course. The next product is one that I love. I've gotten my friends onto this and my family. But this product I spoke about in a video recently actually is the Wella Luxe Oil. This is a reconstructive elixir for keratin protection. So I've had this for quite a long time now and I've only used up half of it. It smells amazing, and who doesn't want to have nice smelling hair? I use this when I get out of the shower before I brush my hair. P.S. Damn, I don't have that with me. I'm going to put a little photo here of a brush that I used that I was given called the wet brush. And it is a brush that is specifically used to dry your hair, to brush your hair when it's wet. The bristles are really soft and flexible, and they kind of move with your hair as you're brushing it. When your hair is wet, it's really, really vulnerable. So if you're using a brush that's like really stiff, it just pulls the hair instead of brushing softly through it and going with your hair. It doesn't tear my hair out. I don't get these huge clumps of hair when I'm brushing my hair. My hair like never falls out anymore. It's crazy, it never falls out. And then I will dispense, so three pumps of this straight into my hand. I'll just lightly go like this, that it's evenly distributed on both hands. And then I will kind of just comb through the ends of my hair like this. And then I will very lightly brush my hair out, very gently. I always start from the bottom. You should always start from the bottom and work your way up. If you're starting here, you're just pulling the knots all the way down your hair to the end. But if you start here, you're getting rid of those knots there, then kind of just slowly brushing them out. But because this bit here is already brushed out, the knots just work themselves out so much more easily than when you start from up here and you're just moving the whole knot down. So I start from the bottom, I work my way up, and then when I get around this area here, I'm very, very, very careful. Then I will blow dry my hair. I do blow dry my hair because I just prefer the way it looks. And now that my hair is way healthier, I can feel like I can do it and get away with it. I use my Dyson Supersonic. I love that thing. Once I blow dry it, I will use one more pump of this. I will really generously distribute it over my hands and then just kind of go over one last time to smooth everything down and just kind of just lock in my hair. I was worried about using this so heavily because I'm like, it's an oil. Surely it's gonna weigh your hair down. Surely it'll build up. Surely I can't use it every single day, but you literally use it every day and it will not build up. It is so amazing. I've never had like greasy feeling ends. It absorbs so quickly. It doesn't react badly to heat. I'm now using the Luxe Oil Reconstructive Mask, I think, as my conditioner. And then I have the Luxe Oil Shampoo and Conditioner that I will use. I use a shampoo all the time, obviously, but the conditioner and the mask I switch between just haphazardly. It's not really anything that I plan or anything. And last but not least, you've just got to be patient. Patience is the biggest thing here because, unfortunately, hair grows slowly. Like, that's just the way it is. You can't really change that unless you, I mean, taking hair pills and hair vitamins can help, but I mean, you're not going to grow like a meter long set of hair in a couple of months. Like, it's just not going to happen. When you stop thinking about it so much, when I stopped focusing on my hair and fussing about, oh my God, it's not this long, it's not long, it's not long, and just accepted the fact that I was going to keep it short, it grew like crazy. Like, that's just the way things work. Also, it's worth mentioning that if you do have an issue with your hair growing and you tried everything and nothing seems to be helping and it's only getting worse, it could be a medical condition. I've got an underactive thyroid and that usually causes hair loss and slow hair growth and like brittle nails and stuff like that, but I haven't been having those issues. I mean, it's borderline underactive. It's not fully underactive, but if you've got underactive thyroid, that can be a really common issue that you have. I'm obviously not a doctor, so I'm not going to give out medical advice, but it's definitely worth considering if you are having issues that you can't seem to get on top of. Definitely go and speak to a GP because there's really no harm in it. I'm sorry if this video is disappointing. I was worried that people would be like expecting some kind of miracle pill or miracle cure, but it's really that simple. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. I'll have all of my links in the description box as always. And yes, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you all. Hope you guys have a great day and I'll see you later. Bye.